So some of you may think, oh my gosh, like having sex with a tree or a plant. No, it's not exactly that. It's a little bit different. It's more of this like meditative exchange of really allowing your body to connect on an energetic level with a plant, right? Or with a flower. Hey guys, my name is Olivia and this is the Be Successful Podcast. I am a sex and intimacy guide, helping guide your transformation through sacred sexuality and spiritual intimacy. So today I want to talk about eco sex and eco sexuality. So this is a topic that has been super expansive for me. Now, one of my first experiences with eco sex, or what I describe as sacred energy exchange, or exchanging your energy with the earth, with plants, with nature, with trees. I mean, anything that flowers even too. This was a recent conversation that came up. So I had a beautiful experience in the Vita retreat, and I'll just share my experience from the retreat. So I did a powerful yoni egg self-pleasure session in nature. And this was something for me that was really pushing me out of my comfort zone. Yet you can say I'm always this fairy energy that has a deep relationship with plants, with trees. I mean, for me, it's like I used to, when I was working, whenever I was stressed out or, you know, feeling a lot of emotions at work, I would go to the tree and I would just simply lean my back against it and just ask the tree to, you know, take some of this heaviness away, you know, allow me to release that, this energy that's in resistance or that's really weighing me down, or maybe I was too much in my head. And I think one of the first experiences I had was just being by the tree and allowing myself to cry. And it was such an easy way to be vulnerable and really allow myself to release. And even if it's not in the presence of someone else, I feel like even trees were those first examples of how to tap into more of my emotions and allow that release in such a gentle, healing, and loving way. So shout out to the trees, love them. And then as I started exploring more sexuality and self-pleasure practices, I started to realize actually you can form an even deeper connection with trees and with plants because they are alive, right? So because they're alive, they have energy running through them. And there's a way that you can tap into that energy and really use it to transmute. So as I talked about releasing, you can also even activate with trees. You can activate with plants, with, you know, Mother Earth. And so some of you may think, oh my gosh, like having sex with a tree or a plant. No, it's not exactly that. It's a little bit different. It's more of this like meditative exchange of really allowing your body to connect on an energetic level with a plant, right? Or with a flower. In this case, we're gonna stick to trees. And I remember too, probably the first experience I had with this is just noticing that when I was able to start to tune into my body and my energy, I started to realize my body was becoming activated. So in this sense, it was like tingles, literally, maybe even like goosebumps going through my body and really almost like activating it and in a sense, turning me on, right? And the turn on is a little different. It's more, I would say, like a subtle energy. So it's this subtle energy that's running through everything that's alive. But when we come with presence and we really consciously enter those spaces, we can tap into this more of a sensational experience with the energy and allow it to, you know, come through our bodies and really flow through. So in this experience, when I was on the retreat, it was a yoni egg experience where we were doing sex magic outside. So sex magic breath work. In this case, there was more self-pleasure of like maybe touching the body or touching areas of the body to really warm the body up and begin that process of allowing the eros and the turn on to move through. And it was such a powerful experience to just feel the energy around me of the living beings, the living plants, and just allowing that energy to begin to cycle and run through. And I just remember as I was breathing, doing my breath work, my body really started to become activated and started to really tune in to pleasurable sensations. And it was definitely like a gentle current running through the body. And with the breath, it's like the more you breathe, the more you move and sound, you start to liberate more of that energy in your body. And this is a huge experience for me. So as I was doing the breath work, I was just like connecting with the trees, with the sun, really feeling just like the heat and the warmth of the sun on my skin. And then also just like each brush of wind would come through. And I was just like so attuned to all the sensations in my body that it's like any touch became pleasurable in that activated state. And, yeah, within that experience, as I was doing the sex magic breathwork practice, I was able to get it to a state and heightened state that eventually I did orgasm. Now, the yoni egg was inserted inside me. So on that time, I was a little more energetically attuned to, you can say my yoni and my inner world, that I was able to access that state of orgasm without any, you can say, traditional stimulation of the clitoris or of that part of my body. So it was really a meditative expression of the energy moving through my body. And sure, there was like movements I was doing, but there wasn't just that like, oh, full on clitoral vulva stimulation. It was completely internal, and what I also call this internal orgasm. And it's almost like this energy that builds up inside you that when you're really able to just surrender and let go, you can access that orgasmic state without any physical outer stimulation. So it's more internal, and your body is almost, you can say, like contracting in a way that's not really controlled by your mind, but your body just starts to tune in to the natural contractions of pleasure, of orgasm and orgasmic states. So that experience was so liberating to one, be in nature, feel so free, feel so just connected to my body, to the world really, right? The universe, the world around me. And I was inspired to share this because I think we neglect that there are so many opportunities for us to connect to our body sensationally and energetically, especially when it comes to maybe just even going for a walk, right? Going for that morning run and then being able just to, after going for that run, sitting by a tree, sitting somewhere just to ground down. The energy of plants and nature is so grounded that it really allows us to get out of our head and more into the body, into this really slower flow that I love teaching about. And another beautiful experience I had was being able to really connect with flowers in a new way. So this was amazing. I was almost like doing a challenge of, it was like a self-pleasure challenge, which I did create. It's actually, I'll leave the link in there, but it's a self-pleasure, challenge of 21 days. And it's really about pushing yourself to explore new ways of self-pleasure that maybe aren't what you're traditionally taught. I feel like most of us get into this habit of doing self-pleasure in one specific way, whether we're using a toy or a vibrator, and we become dependent on orgasming or finding pleasure in that specific way. And I have found that when we start to explore new ways of turn on, new ways of exploring our bodies, that self-pleasure, that orgasmic, even it's not even orgasm that becomes the goal. It's like this process of unfolding, of learning about your body starts to make you more fulfilled when it comes to your own self-pleasure practice. When you're in intimate experiences, it tends to go outside I would just say it goes to transfer into all of your sexual experiences. And so this experience that I had with a flower, I was just meditating once again. And at this time, I believe it was an orchid that was planted. I had an orchid that was in a flower pot. And I just remember, you know, I was like, okay, like, I want to set aside this, you know, 30 minutes to just, you know, experience self-pleasure in a new way. So I remember I was like, okay, I'm just gonna like stay on my bed, look at the flower, and just start to really connect with the energy of the flower. And what I started to notice is just starting to almost like melt into this way of being that really wasn't asking me of much. It was just expecting me to breathe and to like sit with my body. And as I was going through this experience, I was connecting more with the flower. And it was almost as if like each time I was breathing, I was pulling the energy from the flower in and allowing that connection to, you can say, penetrate me, right? And so in an energetic sense, I was allowing the energy of the flower to really start to touch me, right? Like in an energetic sense. And, you know, at that point, I believe that I just started going into just exploring my body and just really tuning in. And I was almost able to enter into that turned on state way easier than I even expected. It was like, okay, maybe, you know, you have a pattern of always going for porn or something specific when actually all around you is something that you can connect to and tune into your body and what it needs. So that was another eye-opening experience. And it's like once I experienced that level of self-pleasure and connection to plants, I was then able to start to take it into my sexual experiences, into my intimacy with partners. And it's almost like the plants and the trees were almost setting me up to tune into these frequencies of more of these relaxed states to allow more of the human energetic connection and physical connection, I would say at this point. So yeah, I mean, ecosexuality has been a massive teacher for me for how to really learn to, relax and, you know, surrender to my body, surrender to the present moment, in a way that is feels safe and feels held. And, probably the other story that's coming up, the experience that I had was when I was in Glastonbury. And in Glastonbury, I went to the area where they have the well. And it's a very beautiful park. And they say the sacred waters of that spring that's there in the well have a lot of healing properties. And there's a lot more history around that maybe we'll get into in another episode. But specifically, I was called to these two yew trees. And if you've ever been there, there's like these two main yew trees. And, you know, I was called to just connect with one of the trees there. And I think at this time, I was deep in my exploration of calling in a divine masculine partner, really calling in a partner that I can feel safe with, that I can surrender to, really a partner that, yeah, knows how to hold space for me. And I remember going to sit by the tree, and I was just, you know, really just asking the tree, you know, what wisdom does it have to share? You know, what do I need to release? What do I need to activate? You know, is there anything that it can share with me on this topic? And what was so powerful is as I was meditating with the tree, I began to feel this energy of once again, of this like grounded relaxation. And that wave of energetic pleasure started to go through my body. But in this sense, it was a little different because it was almost like the tree, as I was like leaning against the tree was telling me and showing me, this is what it feels like to be in the presence of a masculine that can hold you. And it was almost like telling me, like, you haven't had this level before, but we're showing you what this feels like in your physical body. So it definitely felt like an upgrade of one in my nervous system. How can I really receive that level of support, that level of safety, and to start to attune my body into what that experience is like? And I swear it really was. It really felt like physically it was like a man holding me. And I was like, wow, like this feels so juicy. You know, I haven't had this yet, you know, in a partnership, and maybe I've gotten tastes of it. So, but this was like a new level of like a relaxed and calm connection with a partner that I feel in the past, mostly it was a lot of attachment. It was a lot of like high anxiety. So even when those relaxed states were there, you know, I was still maybe going back to my old patterns of the anxiety and attachment. So yes, like with all that being said, nature, trees, I mean, they have been the most profound teachers for me when it comes to sex, when it comes to relationships, and just even, you know, practicing being vulnerable. Really, you know, being able to talk to a tree, even if it sounds crazy, it's like you talk to the tree to really share your desires, you know, share what's on your heart, what you need support, what you need help with. And it's just been revelation after revelation of how powerful nature is to heal us, right? To really take us to this new level of being in our bodies, you know, whether it is sexual, whether it is just safety in itself. I think all of these things play into when we're trying to attract partnerships that we are craving, that really truly can hold space for us and can hold space for all of our versions. So I hope this story about eco sex and connecting with trees and nature really inspires you to take a walk and start looking at trees and at flowers a little bit differently. And don't forget, always ask for permission before exchanging your energy with the tree. I will say sometimes the trees or the plants like little offerings. Sometimes I offer water if I have some, but anything of an offering usually is what I have heard them ask for. So definitely tune in to future episodes. My name is Olivia. Once again, you can connect with me at Pretty Gypsy Dreams on Instagram. I also offer a 15-minute intimacy tune-up session where you get to really experience if there's any blocks or energy keeping you away from your most intimate desires. So that is a free 15-minute healing session with me. You can find that link below and connect with me and stay tuned for more.